Pollutants are deposited on roadways at a constant daily rate as a function of traffic studies as follows. A 7/8-inch storm event will wash 91% of the accumulated pollutants into the stormwater flow. Assuming an interstate with four 4-meter lanes, a drainage area length of 1,500 meters, and 7 days since the last rain event, the average metals concentration, ignoring any accumulation from prior storm events, is most nearly A, 125, B, 150, C, 175, or D, 200. Pause the video and give yourself 5 minutes to complete the problem. Have you finished solving the problem? Let's see if you got the correct answer. Today we'll be discussing pollutants that end up in stormwater runoff. Stormwater runoff is water from rain or melting snow that runs off across the land instead of seeping into the ground. The runoff is not treated in any way, and it is usually flowing to lower areas into the nearest streams, creeks, rivers, lakes, or oceans. On its way, runoff water can pick up and carry many substances that pollute water. Some, like pesticides, fertilizers, oils, and soaps, are harmful in any quantity. Others, like sediment from construction, heavy metals from roads, bare soil or agricultural land, or even grass clippings and leaves, can harm creeks, rivers, and lakes in sufficient quantities. In addition to rain and snowmelt, various human activities like watering, car washing, and malfunctioning septic tanks can also put water onto the land surfaces. Here, it can also create runoff that carries pollutants to creeks, rivers, and lakes. Polluted runoff generally happens anywhere people use or alter the land. For example, in developed areas, none of the water that falls onto hard surfaces like roofs, driveways, parking lots, or roads can seep into the ground. These impervious surfaces can create large amounts of runoff that picks up pollutants. The runoff flows from gutters and storm drains into streams. Runoff not only pollutes but erodes stream banks, and the mix of pollution and eroded dirt muddies the water and causes problems downstream. So the first thing we need to do is see which pollutant concentrations we need to pick based off of our scenario. We have a 4-lane interstate and we are looking for the average concentration of metals. The first mistake many test takers will take is to simply sum all of the concentrations in the interstate column without realizing that phosphorus is not a metal. So you do not need to include this pollutant's concentration in your calculations. So we will combine the pollutant concentrations for cadmium and copper for an interstate, and then multiply this combined concentration by the lanes, the length of drainage area, and the number of days since the last rain event, and we get a total mass of 68.754 kilograms, which is equal to 6.87 times 10 to the 7th power milligrams. We will multiply this mass by 91%, the percentage that will end up in stormwater runoff, and we get the pollutant mass of 6.26 times 10 to the 7th power milligrams. Now we will calculate the volume of stormwater runoff. So we need the drainage area dimensions as well as the height of the rain event. This was a 7/8-inch rain event, and we can calculate the drainage area using the number and width of lanes along with the drainage area. So using this information, we can plug it into the volume equation of length times width times height, and we get a volume of 533.4 cubic meters. Since there are 1,000 liters in 1 cubic meter, we can make this conversion, and we get about 533,000 liters. Finally, we will divide the metals mass by the runoff volume, and we get an average metals concentration of 117 milligrams per liter, which is closest to A. Join us for episode 14 of 52 PE exam problems in 52 weeks.